Hey guys, I'm Ryan Wright.
Hi, I'm Lauren Gaw.
Am I still red?
Slightly.
I was crying earlier. We're going to do a trailer review, reaction, yada, 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 for the night before official Red Band trailer number one, starring JGL and Seth Rogen.
Love both of them.
Yeah, man. They're fucking awesome. 50-50 show. They could work well together. Yeah. Let's see what they can offer up this time, huh?
The children were snuggled, their presents wrapped thorough. But this tale's not about presents, or Santa, or...
Anthony Mackie!
It's about three dudes, three bros, three ride-or-die homies.
Gentlemen, 14 years ago this very night,
I lost my parents.
And you guys have been with me every single Christmas since then.
You knew.
But tonight, we have decided to end this tradition. Chris is just too fucking famous to hang out with us anymore. And Isaac's about to have a baby. This is for you.
A Wu-Tang onesie?
Yeah.
And ain't nothing to fuck with. Wu-Tang Clan. Nothing to
okay,
fuck
okay.
With.
They can hear that.
You have to rock throughout this whole pregnancy. You're like my Dwayne Johnson.
Thank you.
Tonight, just focus on yourself.
Holy shit! Shrooms? Is this cocaine? I haven't done cocaine for 11 years, I don't think.
Yeah, no one has, I don't think. Yeah.
I have a present for you. We're going to the best Christmas party in New York City. So that gives us several hours to hit as many traditions as possible.
To the end of an era.
I think the cocaine and the mushrooms are reacting. Poorly?
Are you gonna be cool at this party?
Cool as fuck, G.
You look insane. Only your right eye is working.
Do I look weird now?
Yes, you look weird. Still weird.
Ah!
Weirder.
You guys, Miss Term singing Miley Cyrus, she destroyed Wrecking Ball.
You still like that song?
Everybody does.
You can cry to it. You can run to it.
Yeah.
You can party to it.
Timeless.
I came in like a wrecking ball.
I'm gonna be honest. I'm freaking out about having the baby. I'm supposed to be a rock, but I'm not a rock.
How fucked up are you right now?
Hallelujah!
Not that kind of church.
No. Who's that guy?
What guy?
Is that what they think we did to him?
Yeah.
Can they tell I'm Jewish?
Yes. Your fucking sweater. Don't you dare throw up in here. Swallow it like a girl would.
I need a barf bag.
Barf bag. It's still happening a little.
Oh, I've been having a pretty crazy night. I'm gonna level with you. I'm a little fucked up right now.
Oh, hi, I love you.
I love it.
Oh, the church jokes really got me. I grew up in Catholic school, so I can understand the humor there very well with a Jew out of water. So, yeah, that was good. This looks like it could be like a dramedy, actually, as compared to what they've done in the past, which is just pretty much straightforward comedy. This looks like there's going to be like dramatic elements to it, or more adult.
Oh, yeah, definitely more adult elements, but I think that it goes along the same lines as the other movies that they've come out with.
Yeah, there's similar humor, similar dick jokes and drugs and stuff, but it still seems more realistic, if anything, you know? Like, this seems like a rather toned-down version of what they've kind of done before to me.
Really?
Yeah, a little bit.
I feel like I don't agree.
Wow, Lauren, we are at differences.
Yeah.
We are at odds here.
This happens a lot.
This happens too much. I wonder how we got along in the beginning.
I don't know. Nah, we still don't get along.
We try. We believe there's a friendship. There's potential for a good friendship.
Yeah, we try. We work on it. Friendships are work.
Yeah, if you care. They do have their token black friend here.
They do.
But I love that actor.
They also have Mindy Kaling in there, so they have a token Indian.
There's ethnicities in there.
But there is no Asian. I did not see one Asian.
They could have at least gotten the guy who played Harold, John Cho.
Yeah.
They could have at least gotten him. Yeah, he's good for these kind of comedies. I'm surprised I've never seen him in one of their films before. Right? He's perfect for these kind of films.
I feel like these are very bro-y films. Like, you gotta be, like, friends already. And they're like, oh, let's make a movie together. And then they have this.
What's your bro-y noise? What's your bro-y voice?
Oh, let's make a movie together. Right? Was that what I did before? No.
To me, the funniest part of the trailer was when it said, almost... the interview.
Yeah, right?
But the black guy, Anthony Mackie, he is a really cool actor. He's in Avengers.
Oh, I was like, recognize him. I just couldn't.
He's Falcon.
Yeah, yeah.
He's Captain America, Winter Soldier. He's done a bunch of other films, actually. Did you see, whatchamacallit? It's that one film with Matt Damon, Emily Blunt. The Adjustment Bureau?
No, I did not see that.
Okay, well, then we can't proceed with this next conversation.
Well, you know, good for him to transitioning to comedy.
My favorite thing is when you see, like, serious actors, like, commit to a comedy.
Mm-hmm.
That is, you know, character-based, dialogue-driven kind of comedy. Joseph Gordon-Levitt, we've seen him do comedy before, I mean, but he's such a seriously taken actor now that it's really cool whenever he slips into a comedy again.
Well, I really feel like comedy is actually harder than drama.
Really? Why do you say that?
As an actor?
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
Why do you say that?
I mean, I think a lot of people will say the same thing. I mean, especially like with the way comedy is written, like you have to be very specific about how you're getting the jokes out. Like you have to be really on top of that. Like versus like a drama where there's a lot more breathing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I also feel that with comedy, you're trying to create something that will make people universally across the globe laugh, which is a lot harder because usually a comedy will tend to like certain kind of crowds.
Right.
But trying to make it like a global, millions of people phenomenon kind of humor is pretty hard.
And also, if you're like watching a comedy and you don't laugh, or you're like, that wasn't a good comedy. But if you're watching a drama and you don't cry, I don't think you're going to be like, that wasn't a good drama.
True. Well pointed out, Lauren.
I'm very astute sometimes.
Astute. That means, whale's vagina.
Yes, it does.
San Diego.
Yes, it does.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like a fun movie. It looks like it's going to be a lot more heart, I feel.
Yeah, I think it'll end up being one of your feel-good holiday movies because they always have to, like, bring that back around.
Yeah, but like Seth Rogen style.
Yeah, but it's still going to be hilarious and fun and entertaining.
We'll be there.
Yeah.
We'll be there.
I'm going to see it.
To celebrate Jewish Christmas. Is that a thing?
Christmaka.
Christmaka. Chris, I sound like a terrorist when I say that. Chris McCaw. Is that a real thing?
That's a real thing. You've never heard of it?
Then I'm cutting out that joke. Anyway, guys, thanks for tuning into the channel. If you're new to it, you can subscribe to The Real Rejects. You can follow Lauren's channel. Yay. Check it out. You can follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Vine, Periscope. She has a Snapchat, too. Because if we get more followers, we can get even more product placement. We need more cha-cha-ching. Josh Rahimer.
John
Rahimer. Hi. I just wanted to say, love the show.
Ah.
Currently one of my daily doses vids. Keep it up. Oh, and check out Conan. Yeah, I saw that. It's short but awesome. John Rahimer. Dude, the fact that this is one of your daily doses is awesome. You know what will add to the daily dose? And Lauren can back me up on this one.
Mm-hmm.
Heroin dosage. Inject heroin and then watch The Real Rejects. Best experience ever. I know there's kind of a kid demographic on here.
Yeah.
Wait till you're 18. I'll say that much.
Yeah, I'm not really endorsing that.
You're not?
No.
Why?
I mean, he's right. It probably will make it a more enjoyable experience.
Okay.
But no, I'm not going to endorse the drug usage.
You know someone who did heroin, don't you?
I don't. I don't think...
Oh.
To my knowledge, I don't know anyone who's done heroin. I guess I do know someone who's done heroin. Have you done heroin?
I would like people to believe I did heroin.
Oh, okay. So to my knowledge, I know one person that's done heroin.
I'm kidding, John. Don't do heroin. But smoke plenty of weed, and trust me, it'll make the channel better.